Okay, resetters, Dr. Mindy here today, and I have something really fun for you. So I'm actually at Systemic Formulas, my favorite supplement company today, doing webinars for doctors to educate them on all the different ways that they can improve the health of their community. And one of the things that we're talking about today is the microbiome. So if you've read my book, The Reset Factor, or The Reset Factor Kitchen, you know that I look at the gut as being this primary part of your health, that if you take really amazing care of it, your health will just flourish. But what I'm finding with patients and with people in the community and conversations that I have is that most people have no idea the extent at which their microbiome functions, that it's way beyond just the gut. So I want to share with you a little bit for the next couple of minutes what I'm actually showing these doctors as well. Because as a community, as a world, we have to think beyond the gut. Even though the microbiome is so powerful, what we have to realize is that you have a microbiome in your mouth, you have a microbiome in your nose, you have a microbiome on your skin, you have a microbiome around every single organ. And your microbiome is constantly communicating with each other. And we actually are more bacterial cells than we are human cells. Now, stop to think about that for a moment. Every time you walk into your doctor's office and they give you a prescription medication, what they're trying to do is manipulate your human cells and maybe even kill your bacterial cells. Same thing in many alternative offices. You're walking in and what they're trying to do is have an effect on the human cells. What I want to hopefully create a mind-blowing effect for you over the next few minutes is that you got to switch your focus to the bacterial cells, because these bacteria are so helpful. They give you neurotransmitters that make you happy and calm your brain. They produce B vitamins that give you energy and allow your brain to have really clear thoughts. They control your whole immune system. So instead of trying to always affect the human cells, let's start to have an effect on the bacterial cells. Now, again, if you've been following me on Facebook for a while, you know that I love to empower you. You know that I love to bring you information so that you can do the research yourself. We live in a time in healthcare where you need to empower yourself. You need to create a team of doctors around you that are for you, not doctors that put you down and tell you there are no answers. So one of my favorite authors and lecturers on the microbiome is Dr. Martin Blaser. If you have not read this book, it's called Missing Microbes, and he has a huge concept that he's concerned about, which is that because of this antibacterial world that we live in, more and more people are destroying the bacteria on their skin, their mouth, their gut, and that we have no good bacteria left. So what ends up happening is we don't even have that helpful bacteria to make our brain happy. I mean, it's that simple. So if you stop and you think about that, I get patients a lot that say to me, well, I try to minimize my antibiotics. If the doctor gives me an antibiotic, I try to minimize it. But guess what? You're getting antibiotics everywhere. If you go out to eat and you order a meat product, most likely you got an antibiotic-rich meat, you know, filled with meat. If you're not buying hormone-free and antibiotic-free meats at home, then guess what? Over time, you're going to end up with an accumulation of antibiotics in your gut. The other area that a lot of people don't realize is all those antibacterial soaps, things you're putting on your hands, all of that is destroying the microbiome on your skin. And guess what? Your skin, the microbiome communicates with the gut. So I see patients all the time that are working so hard to kill candida or affect their SIBO, but then every day they're putting antibacterial soap on their hands or soaps that destroy the skin microbiome. So look at your environment of lotions and beauty products. I'm doing a women's health event on May 19th. I'll put the link in the comments, and we're going to talk about environmental aspects of the microbiome, and we're going to talk about environmental aspects of hormones, but your beauty products are massively destroying your skin microbiome. And then, you know, we've got the air quality is not getting any better. And so there's a whole microbiome in your nose. And if you don't take proper care of that microbiome, Unfortunately, what ends up happening is that you can get like a leaky microbiome in the nose, just like you can get it in the gut. And then that allows toxins to get up into the brain. And then my other favorite one that I love to educate people on is the mouth. So your Colgate, your Crest, all your toothpaste, what that does is it completely destroys the bacteria in your mouth, all of it. Well, guess what? Do you know that you have beneficial bacteria in your mouth? That if you help nurture it and grow that bacteria, what will end up happening is that you can actually break that food down so that when it gets to your gut, it's already pre-digested. So there's prebiotic toothpaste that you can use as well. And all of these are affecting not only your health, but Martin Blaser, he has a concept that he calls the generational handoff. That because we've gotten so obsessed with killing bacteria, that each generation that's coming in is getting a less diverse microbiome and a less diverse microbiome. So understand this from a complete picture, making sure that you are care, what I call the care and feeding of your microbiome, is not just about taking a probiotic. It's about looking at all these different angles and understanding how you have so much control over your health when you grab a hold of this and you understand what you can do to help the skin microbiome and the nose microbiome and the mouth microbiome. And again, I'm so passionate. I deal with a ton of families. And again, May 19th, I'm going to be doing a event for women on how do we empower women to be healthier and then turn around and make the family healthier. And it's all, a lot of the discussion we're going to talk about is environmental impacts on our hormones. And you better believe that the microbiome is going to be a primary piece that we will be talking about. All the solutions to the problems I just showed you, I will be teaching you there. I'm hoping that that day you walk out of there like, I got this. I can do this. I can drive my own health. Because once you have the knowledge, then putting the steps in is just, it's effortless. So I hope that expanded your view. I hope that looked at you, looking at the microbiome different. Those of you that are patients of mine or resetters, you guys, I'd love to know what experience you've had with resetting your microbiome, which products you love that I've been teaching you on. And if you want to come to my Women's Health Day, just put Women's Health in the comment section and I'll send you some information on it. So as always, I hope that helps. And just never, ever, ever forget how ridiculously powerful your body is. You were truly born in a miracle.